concluded, and we're ready for second half of basketball in what has been a tale of two quarters in which a Jam led by 15 after one, and Austin completely turns it around and outscores the Jam in the second quarter, 37-19, thanks to the Curtis Gerald's three-pointer near midcourt to take that three-point lead, led by Lewis Clinch's 14, Dwayne Jones's 37 double-double, 11 points, 12 rebounds. Jam, 11 points, 8 rebounds. Brian Butch, 8 points, 6 rebounds. Holiday Aminu, and 9 points for Jeremy Wise. Here's Trey Johnson inside, and he cuts the lead to 1.
And that's what the Jam need to do here early on in the second half, is get back to exploiting those mismatches, get back to running their offense and getting good looks for everybody, rather than just dumping it in or having guys freelance for themselves on the perimeter.
And now taking it hard to the rack and missing inside is Squeaky Johnson. Jones will go to the line as his stick-to-itiveness earns him 2 freebies. Holiday Aminu is third personal foul and first team foul of the third quarter.
And at this point, Rick, I think we got to say a game where Dwayne Jones doesn't have a first half double-double, it's an upset. Because this guy, just basically every time we've seen him, before he can turn around, he's got a double-double already. And the way he rebounds the ball, boy, I'll tell you, you can start to take it for granted when you watch him a lot, but there's something special about the ability to rebound like he does.
And Dwayne Jones comes up empty on that trip. Jam deficits 1, and now Brian Butch tries a three-pointer that misses. And here comes Austin, one-point lead. Bonner, Johnson, Gerald, Jones, and Joyner. Same starting five for Austin, down to 12 in the shot. Johnson, Aminu, Daniels, Butch, and Wise for the Jam. Here is Jones backing in on Butch, throwing it up and counting. 2 more points for Dwayne Jones, 13 now, and a three-point advantage for Austin. Trey Johnson to a cutting Aminu. He lost it, finds it, gives it to Daniels, who comes up short on the runner, and Baker's coming out of sync here in the third quarter.
And once again, just not taking good shots. I mean, that shot by Will Daniels, he just takes it himself right into a double team and tries to shoot over them. And even if that's a shot you sometimes hit, it's not a shot you want to take early in a shot clock. And there, Curtis Gerald's just again showing what a dynamic scorer he can be, breaking down Trey Johnson off the dribble and sinking a 16-footer.
13 for Curtis Gerald's, 5-point lead for Austin. Will Daniels with it, Aminu. Drives right baseline, had it knocked out of bounds by Luke Bonner, who's been a great addition tonight with 8 points. Jam have 10 seconds with which to work in the shot. In that first half, the Jam shot 43%. Austin shot 53%. Austin hit 6 three-pointers for 38%. Jam only 13%. Only hit 1 of 8 beyond the arc. Here's Johnson with 5 on the shot clock. Gerald's is all over him, finds Butch. Steps in a three-pointer, and he's fouled. It's going to be a 3-shot foul as Dwayne Jones tried to fly out at him. And these are big free throws right now for Bakersfield.
Yeah, no doubt. You can't let Austin start to run away here. I mean, that's just, and especially, nothing has changed since the first half. When this was an Austin team that was unable to match up defensively against the Jam. The only difference is the Jam are not moving the ball around, and they're not getting good looks. They're not getting those mismatches that they were getting in the first half, and now, once again, not getting foul shots to go either.
Everything that was falling last night for the Jam isn't, and seems to be falling the other way as Butch makes his 2nd of 3. Bakersfield is now 15 of 22 from the line, 67%. Austin is 14 of 22. Excuse me, 13 of 22, just under 60%. Jam had the rebound advantage at half, 26-20. Turnovers 10-8, Austin. 2 of 3 for Brian Butch. Jam deficit is 3, and Butch has 13 points. Here's Squeaky Johnson, hands off to Jones, back to Johnson, now Bonner. In the corner with 6 on the shot. Bounce pass, batted away, and Bonner's going to step in, try a 16-footer and come up short. But Bonner follows his own miss and gets a rebound and a new 24. And great hustle again.
Yeah, great hustle by Bonner, but not great hustle by the Jam. You can't let the shooter get his own rebound on that play.
And now Brian Butch is going to get called for a foul under the basket on Dwayne Jones. And that'll be personal foul number 3, second team foul. It's on the floor. So side out for Austin. And Luke Bonner will inbound.
And Butch can avoid that foul by just pulling his hand out of there a little sooner. You know, he had already lost that rebound, had a chance to avoid the foul, but sort of kept harassing Dwayne Jones and ended up drawing another personal foul.
Here's Austin with the ball on the deck. Lost it. Squeaky Johnson loses it. Bakersfield the other way, and Squeaky Johnson, a frustration foul there on a hit from behind.
And that's good hands by Brian Butch. As Squeaky tried to dish that across the lane, Butch reached out, knocked it up in the air, and right into the hands of Alade Aminu.
And Lewis Clinch will head in for Squeaky Johnson, who's assessed with fourth personal. Each team with two team fouls. Jeremy Wise with it. Gerald's on him. Now Johnson has it. Left wing beyond the three-point line. And it's going to be a Luke Bonner foul away from the ball. His second personal, team foul number 3. And the Jam will inbound in front of the Austin bench with 15 on the shot clock. Daniels with it. He will try to find Wise, which he does. Screen by Aminu. Aminu dives the basket. Wise didn't see him. Now he passes to a cutting Will Daniels in a two-handed flush for right. Will Daniels. This has 9.
And that's the kind of offense the Jam were getting in that first quarter, where they ran out to the big 15-point lead. And that's just moving without the basketball, getting into good position, and getting a nice pass from the point guard. That's what basketball's supposed to look like.
And now Gerald's with a penetration, the kick out. Bonner misses on the three-point attempt. And Brian Butch comes down with the board. Rebound number 9 for Butch as he approaches another double-double. Aminu, pump fake on the 16-footer into the paint. And off the heel with the jump hook. And Dwayne Jones with his 14th rebound. 60-59 Austin. Screen by Luke Bonner. He's going to be whistled for the illegal screen. And that's his third personal, team foul number 4. And with 8:11 to go, Jam have a chance here. Excuse me, make it 3 team fouls. That's an offensive foul. So 3 team fouls for Austin. Bakersfield with 2. Jam will inbound as Michael Joyner returns the lineup to replace Bonner. Wise, bad pass, but Trey Johnson able to get it in the corner. Left baseline drive, backing in on the smaller Gerald's. Into the paint, great hands by Gerald's, and a kick by Trey Johnson, thanks to the quick hands of Gerald's.
Yeah, Gerald's knocked that right out of Trey's hands as he tried to take that up for the shot, and Trey's feet kind of flying up in the air hit the ball. But another turnover for the Jam, where really very little offense is run. It's just Trey posting up against Gerald's, not really getting an advantage. And that time, Gerald's just right past him for the hammer with the left hand.
Wow, Curtis Gerald's again. 13 now. 13 points, 30 last night. A three-point lead for Austin. Here's Trey Johnson near the right hash. 10 on the shot. Will Daniels wide open, tries a triple. And that one barely grazed the front of the rim. Here comes Austin. The Jam's three-point shooting has been woeful. And Squeaky Johnson misses on the bounce, and we've got a loose ball foul. It's going to be on Butch, his fourth personal. Third team foul. And Will Voigt wants an explanation from C.J. Washington. As John Edwards will have to replace Brian Butch in the Jam lineup.
C.J. Washington telling Will Voigt that he's pushing Dwayne Jones in the back. Coach Voigt asking how that can be when he's using both his hands to rebound the ball. Again, though, just a bad spot for a technical foul for Coach Voigt. You've already given the Toros a chance to stretch their lead back to 5. Now you give them an extra opportunity here at the line, and you give them an opportunity with a guy who's actually a good shooter rather than Dwayne Jones. When you foul him, at least it's Dwayne Jones at the free throw line. So the Jam really struggling since that first quarter and starting to feel the frustration clearly.
6 points now for Squeaky Johnson. Jeremy Wise has just whistled for his third personal foul, fourth team foul. So the Jam come out on the attack, get Austin to commit the team fouls. Now the Jam have more than Austin with four. And now Michael Joyner will inbound to Gerald's. Plenty of time on the shot, 15. Finds a wide open Joyner, and Will Daniels, Aminu rejects him, but he's going to get whistled for a foul. Down low, Aminu the foul.
And that appears to be a foul for hitting the ball too hard on the blocked shot. Because I'm not sure exactly what else it's for. And right now, it's just this whole game, and it's been both ways. There have been entirely too many touch fouls called in this ball game. Whether it's guys not quite keeping their hands straight up in the air on the defensive end. In that case, a block where maybe a little body contact, but really a very clean-looking block shot for Alade Aminu there. And, you know, again, we've seen it both ways all night long. Just a very, very quick whistle for all three referees in tonight's game.
One of two for Michael Joyner. That's his first point of the game. Jam deficit is five. Now Wise into the paint by Squeaky. Puts it up with a left hand, and it wouldn't go down as Dwayne Jones comes down with it, clears out, and it's going to be a foul on Will Daniels. Third personal foul, 15 foul, and Austin in the bonus at the 6:46 mark as Reese Gaines returns to the Jam lineup with three fouls himself. And at the rate we're going tonight, we're going to get out of here about 11:30 with all the fouls being called tonight.
Indeed, it's been about as foul-heavy a game as I can ever remember seeing at any level. Right now, a total of 41 fouls between these two ball clubs. And that's just a lot of fouls, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, there's no other way to cut that one.
One of two for Dwayne Jones. He now has 14. 14 points for Jones. 6-point disadvantage for Bakersfield. Here's Will Daniels to Jeremy Wise in the left wing. Eight on the shot. John Edwards has it. Spins, turnaround 12-footer, got it. Nice touch by Big E.
Yeah, and John's been one of the guys who's really had it working tonight. That makes him 4-7 on the evening. He's got 8 points, and boy, again, Curtis Gerald is just right through the teeth of the defense. No one putting a body on him. Nobody stopping him from getting right to the rim. And you know he's going to score, but too many of his buckets, especially here in the second half, have been so easy.
Curtis Gerald's now with 17 points. Jam and a half court set. Six on the shot. Reese Gaines left baseline drive, and he missed with the lay-in.
And that's a number of times now the Jam have just missed from point-blank range on shots like that. And boy, just after the first quarter, about as poor a performance as you could have possibly expected from this Jam team.
6-point Austin lead with 5:36 to go. Jones turns on Edwards. Into the paint, great hands by Edwards on the strip. Here comes the Jam. Wise up and in.
And that one nearly popping out as well. Jeremy apparently trying to set a record for number of times hitting the rim on the inside of the rim, much not no less, without it going in.
And Lewis Clinch misses on the long two, but guess who's there on the weak side for the rebound? Dwayne Jones. And a fresh 24.
That's only 18
Jones
rebounds
spins,
tonight.
Reverse layup, count the bucket, and one.
And all Dwayne Jones has done is now 16 points, 18 rebounds in tonight's ball game, and he is just a specimen on the boards. I don't know that I've ever seen anything like it.
69-63 Austin leads. Jones has one shot forthcoming. We step away for a timeout on NBA.com/D League.